Welcome to the Mists of Time. We have breaking news for all you pyramids lovers. Aliens didn't build them. Yes, I know it's quite shocking news. The pyramids of ancient Egypt are so mysterious that for some people they can only be the result of extraterrestrial technology.
Many theories have been proposed to explain how Bronze Age Egyptians built these huge royal tombs. Some people thought an army of slaves pulled sleds with huge stones on them. Cranes didn't exist at the time, and to hold the sleds on top of the pyramid, you had to build some kind of ramp. Modern-day tests show that sleds force you to build ramps with a low slope. In the end, this means the ramp that goes up to the top of the tomb would have been very expensive. The sled-ramp combo isn't particularly efficient, but we know from ancient sources that the Pyramid of Khufu was built in just 23 years.
In other words, they quarried, carved and positioned an astonishing number of 300 blocks per day. A very expensive operation, if done by using sleds. So, how were the pyramids built?
Enter the Rolling Stone Mechanism! The specialized pyramid builder tool can satisfy all your hauling needs. Say goodbye to your grandfather's sled. Call the number 2347 and text Osiris to buy the new Rolling Stone Mechanism for a very special price.
Let me explain what this tool is actually about. In the year 19 BC, the Roman architect Vitruvius wrote about a temple in Greece that was built by rolling large stone blocks using a special device. It was kind of a wheel, in which the stone was encapsulated. Ancient Greeks knew how to roll a huge square stone in place. But did the Egyptians too?
Look no further than the Metropolitan Museum of New York, where you'll find many artifacts found in Queen Hatshepsut's temple. Among these artifacts, there are scale models of building tools. There are some wooden semicircles with dowels. In the past, their use was misinterpreted as stone rockers. A crazy theory, that's a story for another day. Actually, they are models of device for rolling stones, obvious proof of ancient Egyptian knowledge. A modern test has shown that a rolling stone mechanism could be used by a team of 6 men on a ramp of 1 to 12 ratio slope. By using a sled, 30 men were needed. But there's more. The rolling stone mechanism could be used on a breathtaking ramp of 1 to 4 ratio by just 10 men. Ancient Egyptians were practical people who obviously took a liking to this tool. But why have we only found a few rolling stone devices compared to the many ancient sleds?
Possibly, sleds could be used for many purposes, like moving any kind of bulky cargo, while the rolling stone device had a singular use, the construction of a pyramid. Apparently, once a pyramid was constructed, the rollers were recycled into less specialized tools, leaving nary a trace behind. Ancient Egyptians recycled wood whenever possible, on account of having to import timber from Lebanon at exorbitant costs. But who taught Egyptians the secrets of the rolling stone mechanism? Aliens, of course.